forgot if I bought med packs on this character or if I bought them on another character. I don't remember. But we're going to buy 10 anesthetics. And we're going to buy... Oh. That sucks. I don't want to buy cages. Those are terrible. Did I buy med packs? Let me look at my equipment. No, I did not buy med packs. We do have probes to use, too. Okay, so we're going to buy med packs. Regular med packs. We'll buy 10. Alright, and now we'll leave to go on an adventure. Whoa. Okay. So, we haven't checked out any of this. Let us check it outside. That's another one of those pirate war planets, and it's also corrosive, so that's double bad. Covered completely in liquid. I see some not liquid there, but I'll go ahead and take your word for it anyway. No. Dense and exotic with a high probability of life, so I'm probably not getting a full picture of this planet that I scanned with that one little mountain peak showing up. And I was right. Turns out this is going to be one of those annoying volcano mountain lava planets, which are so popular with this version of the game, and it's also got sulfuric acid raining on us, and there's a critter. I want to talk to you. Hello. Uh-oh. Are you one of the metal gods who have returned? Yes, and we demand tribute. Of course, and that is right. And then he leaves, without giving us any tribute at all. Ammonium steam and one of our security officers was killed. And our ship's doctor was injured. So why don't we leave before any more of that stuff happens? Bye. So that didn't go well. And I keep trying to scan gas giants. Wow, that's just like Grimmoth and Star Control. Derp. Unrelated space game burn. This one looks like fun. And we even landed right. That's a good omen. Yeah, this is going to be an excellent planet. There's atmosphere. There's, you know, happy little trees. It's like Bob Ross. Oh, God. Fuck. Bob Ross just painted as a happy little meteor explosion. And a happy, terrifying centipede standing on a corpse of something. Let's talk with it. You can't be from another world. Oh, yeah? Oh, yeah? Oh, yeah. He's not going to say anything important. But I would like it if he would kindly get the fuck out of the way so I can scan whatever he's just killed, but he's probably going to eat it. Which is, not how we do things in the name of science. We don't kill things for food or money or economic survival purposes. We kill them for science. You know, in the most philosophical way of thinking about it, we are the ultimate evil. Let's talk to this spider. Wow, these fucking spiders. Oh, he wanted to trade with me. I want to trade with you. Trade with me. Trade. 5,000 zrongs? We taught it some biology and it gave us some zrongs. You want to play with it? Yes. I played with him. I would not play with a giant talking spider. Just saying. Given the opportunity, I would not play with a giant talking spider. I would GTFO after screaming like a little girl. Earth-like atmosphere, 20% probability of life, and I see silver and gold. So go in there. Oh yeah, this is just like Earth. There's fucking lava cracking out of everywhere over all the entire surface of the planet. It's exactly how it is in my backyard right now. Like, I have to be really, really careful when I go out and fucking trim my plants and rake up leaves, because just boom, lava, mountains just spring up out of nowhere. It's happens all the time. It's so annoying. Yeah, just absolutely Earth-like. What the fuck? But I do see that gold up there. It disappeared. Gold disappeared. Ooh. Another scout ship. Oh, I can't steal it. It's actually... Oh, that's why the gold disappeared. Another fucking prospector team landed here and stole it. And now they're going for more ore. Well, I don't know what that ore is, but let's see if we can get there first. It's going for it at 60-0. I don't see anything. And they haven't got whatever it is yet. You'd think they would have got it by now. Maybe they got stuck. Hopefully they'll die and I can steal their equipment. I still haven't spotted them yet either. Is that an actual volcano? I think it is. Smoke. I can't actually see it. Yeah, I can't see it. They're still going for the same piece of ore. Wherever 60... Oh, they got it, and they're going for another one. I don't know if they're on the same planet as I am, because... Oh, hey! Where's that? Oh, there it is! Why don't I just take that for you? Haha, returning the ship. I wonder if it would be unsportsmanlike for me to kill them and take their stuff. Probably. Either way, we got a planet mapped, and we had a little fun in the process. That one was corrosive, so... Not gonna bother. I'm not gonna work here anymore. Bio, off the charts, interesting plants, Earth-like atmosphere, 50% probability of life, and some water. Hey, guys, how are you? They're friendly sentiments. And the science officer remarks, -2, ELO number, Srari, Chevron? Yes, I'll play with you while I fucking slump into a hallucinogenic. Wow, a mammal with a round head, 2 pit eyes, 2 curved horns, and a big mouth. A short neck leads to a wide body with no arms, 4 short legs. Its entire body is covered in feathers, and it is attacking me. And there's a spider monster that's also attacked. Oh, God! Science officer injured, 2 security members injured, science officer killed, ship's doctor killed, squad leader killed. And your pilot remarks, that's pretty much what I'd say, too. An asteroid containing a high amount of silver. Shall we try to take it? Sure! Wow, we actually got it. Normally when you do that with a ship has been hiding in the asteroid attack. Normally when you do that with a low-skill pilot, you will just immediately die. Alright, pilot face. See if you can get us out of here. Foray, run. Not done here. Okay, nothing in those. Most boring piece of rock I ever saw. So, again, the boring rock. But that's a good thing in this case, because that means we can easily snatch up all this resources, map out the planet, and then take our findings home. This is a special type of world. It's sort of like a scripted world or whatever. So, when I found it before, I was acting. I was pretending. I was like, oh my god, oh my god. But really, I've found this one a few times before. It's not so special. Hey, whoa. Wow. This game is taking my key presses fucking seriously. Damn, game. Chill out. For some reason, no other team has already explored this very easy-to-explore world. I kind of think the game should start you off with one of these, just as like a tutorial, so you can get used to walking around, picking shit up, and noticing what is good. Maybe like go through a progression or something like that of progressively shittier planets. Because the first time I played the game, I landed on a corrosive planet that was in the process of being pounded by 1,000 meteorites, and it murdered me quickly. Not that I'm bitter or anything. Oh, then again, the temperature is -16 degrees. That's kind of cold. But we mapped it, and now we can go back to the station as champions. Champions of the universe. We got everything. And a bonus. Way to go, us. Alright, so we're going to do our traditional repairs, refuel, hire our traditional dead people back, which in this case is a doctor. That's not bad, actually. Ship's a doctor. Although we did lose some security folks. Why don't we hire 1 paramedic, 1 squad leader, and 1 sniper? Sure, I don't know. That makes sense, I guess, in a sort of way. We are going to go and train again. Hopefully we've got... Damn it! We've got 4,000 credit bucks. Do you have any stasis fields? Yes. We'll buy... This can hold 10, I think. Oh, 5. So we'll buy 4 of them. That seems like a lot. And it is, which is why I did it. Buy a targeting computer for... Nobody has a gun. For the captain. And then we'll leave. Ooh, there's a secret star there. Dense and exotic with a low probability of life and holy shit, acid! I thought I was gonna finish that sentence and be in good shape. I thought I was gonna be all like, and there's gold laying around. Well, it's gonna be great. But then we landed in acid and it was not great. Bye. Corrosive atmosphere. No. A ship hiding in the asteroids. Where is it? I'm gonna go fucking fight it. And I think I just crashed into an asteroid and it didn't do anything to me. Yeah. Apparently you don't have to dodge these. You can just... Uh-oh. Never mind. You damage your ship hitting the asteroid. Times all of it. Oh, I tried to run away, but it caught up to me. It just wasn't showing up in the combat log. I'm such an idiot. Run. Now go back to the station and fucking waste all our time and money and then repair. Aw, Eric Rees retired. Wait, what did that say? Something about something being okay, but I don't know who Eric Reeves is, but apparently he retired. I guess after a journey like that, I can understand. Can we hire another security guy? Yeah, so whoever left... Yeah, Eric Reeves. He was a green security guy, and he was just like, you know what? You, sir, are a moron. I don't blame him. This one seems nice. I mean, I assume it's nice. We can't see anything on it, but the numbers seem to support the possibility that it will be nice. And the numbers were right. Except for the lack of oxygen, there's plenty of resources, and not a whole lot of danger murder going on. We're gonna need to buy a new gun for our ship, which ought to be kind of expensive. Not super thrilled about that, but if we want to have even the remotest possibility of surviving for more than 5 minutes... Which it's already been, you should note. What the hell? A glect crew blade and some iron. Okay. I love it when I find blades that are from species who have names so complicated I can't even pronounce them. It's my favorite, and we're almost out of oxygen. Let's go back to our show. Uh-oh. Very close, very close. Got it. Nailed it like a glove. And quick little jump down here, make sure there are no hiding goodies. And we're on our way, prospecting outer space. Lots of resources, no atmosphere, no fun. Yes, yes, blah, blah. Turn in our cruds, and I think we can afford a weapon. Now you have to be careful. If you get a railgun, it has a different, damage radius. Heat is the same, it does more damage and it has a higher range. Each of these slots here, shields, weapons, sensors, and engine, those are all module slots, so you can defer, and if you have like two weapon slots, you can use a fuel tank in one of them. We've only got one weapon slot with the default ship, so we're gonna buy a railgun. Okie dokie. That used a fair bit of our money, but now we've got the boom booms. Let's fly in a random direction. Wait a minute. A rogue planet has no star. Naturally, it has no atmosphere. And there's a 100% probability of life. I gotta check this out. Lots of resources, too. I'm dying to find out what this 100% probability of life business is all about. Because that seems very strange, given the circumstances. And I need to be... Oh. Oh, it's friendly. Hello. Well, you are floating around out in the middle of space on a rogue planet. Well, I played with him and he gave me a wooden box. That's not exactly what I was hoping for. I'm guessing this isn't a unique planet like I initially thought it was. But I've never seen a rogue planet before, so at least that bit's fun. And there's some good resources laying around. I think we're going to haul backwards, though. I'll do one trick landing. Get him over here. Because I did see some more resources up yonder. Yonder! Yonder sources of re! Naturally, there's been a great deal of large explosions. Oh, there's a tunnel there. Interesting. And not my kind of tunnel, a different kind of tunnel. Do I dare? Do I dare? I dare. Spoiler warning, I dare. Also, spoiler warning, I probably die. Okay, so we refueled our oxygen, and we're in the tunnel. which will probably mostly just have those not so evil enemies, and wow, it takes a lot to for us to drill through that. But hey, we got Shulfer. Oops, I'm just sort of firing my weapons off at random. Dude, hope there's no friendly aliens on the other side of this that have heavily armed friends that might turn on us at any minute. I'll just be firing my gun like a standard American dumbass. Because guns are sweet. Okay, I think this planet, this tunnel might just be done with. I'm going to check one area here. This is a dead end. Oh boy. Well, kind of a dead end. I think I'm going to get me some bio data before we leave. Hello. Uh-oh. It's badly hurt. Got it. Uh-oh. Sniper killed. Is there... It didn't leave a corpse. Okay, it died. I think we killed it. No, it's critically hurt and tries to flee. Ah! Fuck. Stop it. Are you the critically hurt one? Badly hurt. You'll die. We got you. Biodata. And only two people died! I'd say that was a success failure. That was a success fail mission. I don't think anybody important died, though. Yeah, we still got our important spots. We just lost a couple of green security noobs. Way to go, noobs. It's their fault. Whoa. Thin exotic atmosphere. Low probability of life, even though there's fucking huts on the planet. And there's... What? A high humanoid with long arms and legs, green scaly skin, very light and thin, and its fingers are in sucking cups. I don't think that's what you meant. We love mushrooms. The best mushrooms grow in the caves, but there's a monster there. If we look at our quests now, we have a mission. A small green alien told you about a monster in their mushroom caves. So he wants me to go kill their mushroom monster, and he will give me a reward if I do so. But I'm going to raid their huts first. Give me your hut juices. Okay, we're not finding anything in these huts. And lack of oxygen, real downer. But there's the tunnel. So let's see if I can get into contact with Mark, please. Ship. Oops. I want you to land right there. Thank you for asking. I think I landed it in the right spot. I did. I played Space Invaders. I know how to land. Wait, you didn't land in that game. You just shot aliens. Well then, my green little friends who gave me a quest, things are not looking good for you. Let us go save the... What? Monster? Wow, there's iridescent flowers growing underground. That's pretty cool. Here, monster. Don't worry, guys. It's just toxic gas. No big deal.